10 seconds came up quick.
Yeah. 10-9-8 something.
I was checking on his battery tender.
So what do we got going on, Matt? We got somebody else here.
We got Ricky at Texidor.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I said that right. There we go. So, Ricky, I know you were talking to Rick and you were telling about your business, but motorcycle and tire.
Yes, sir. Motorcycle tires, from sport bike tires to cruisers to your dirt bikes to, I mean, pretty much touring bikes, anything with two wheels, like even four-wheelers. I do four-wheelers also.
Well, there you go. It's just two wheels on both sides.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
So, Ricky, I know you were telling Rick, but where are you located?
Over here in East Orlando on Dean Road.
Dean Road. Okay.
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, now that he's got a bike, now he knows where to get a tire when he's ready.
Oh, what you got for a bike, brother? Oh, you got this beautiful.
So he's not going to need tires for a while, but when he does, he knows the hookup.
How about
I know where to go.
You want to make it quick that you need tires? Do some burnouts. Get a couple of nice burnouts in, then we'll talk, brother.
Hey, so Ricky, you were saying.
See this? I think I'm past that right now.
You were saying, I'm burnt out.
Yeah, there you go.
He was saying all types of bikes, so it's Harley, Indians, dirt bikes.
Yes.
Whatever you got, yes, you know. Sir. You can go ahead and order any, and it could be Michelin, Dunlop,
Pirellis,
whatever it is.
B-rubbers.
Okay.
I mean, you name the tire brand, I can get it.
All right, nice.
Yes, sir.
That's now, typically, when somebody's, say you've got some custom bikes. Mm-hmm. Well, you know, I've got like a 200 on the back of my bike. I mean, mm-hmm. So it doesn't matter sizing and everything like that. I mean, you can go ahead and get the bike, you can get the tires.
200, 240, 50s. 18s, 21s, 23s, 24s, and then also you got your, you know, huge 26s custom in the front, like pretty tires anything, brother.
Okay.
Anything.
So when somebody comes out to your shop, obviously, you know, they make an appointment. It's when the tires are in, you can get them in and out the same day.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, a little birdie told me that you also will do mobile. Why don't you kind of go a little bit into that?
So the deal is with the mobile is that I like to give my customers the comfort of coming to them. Now some people, you know, they don't have the ability to make it out to me because it's either, you know, they have a flat tire or anything like that. Or even, for example, your tires are bald and they're showing strips in the middle. So I offer them the option, hey, you know, if you want me to come to you, I'm available to come to you also.
Okay. Now, why don't you share a little bit, because I've had some guys tell me, oh, I've got a nail in my tire, and it's a fairly new tire, so I'm going to go ahead and patch it. Why don't you share the dangers about patching? Look, you can patch a car tire.
Because you got three more.
Right? But when you're talking a motorcycle, patching the tire, why don't you maybe explain a little bit about that?
I will be honest with you. Patching a motorcycle tire is not bad. And here's the thing, I'll explain why. Here's the thing, gentlemen. What's bad is plugging a tire.
Okay.
You have guys who plug their tires, and I'll tell them, I was like, listen, you know, if you want to plug your tire, that's fine. Use it to get you home or come to me, and that's it. But if you ride on it, think about it. It's going to pull the plug out eventually over time. So what I like to do different is I like to patch it from the inside. But I have a limit to where I patch it. If it's in within the middle of the tire and not on the sidewalls, then I'm like, you know what? You can go ahead and patch it. I'll patch it from the inside and you're safe.
Wow.
There.
I didn't know that. I didn't either.
I've been patching a tire.
Now I can see what he's saying, plugging a tire. There's a difference between plugging and patching a tire. But okay.
Exactly.
That's a beautiful bike though.
Because again, plug a tire. It's not that secure. Think about it. It's just hanging in there, and it's just doing this inside.
Awesome.
If the rope grips it enough, it's going to pull it back out. What's going to happen? All the air is going to be out, and then you know what happens from there. It's not a pretty scene. But all said and done, when I do patch a tire, I do tell my customers, listen, it's fine to patch, but do not go crazy.
Okay.
All right. Because, I mean, come on.
Yeah.
Kind of common sense, you know what I mean, brother?
No, a lot of people don't know what you mean. That's the problem, Ricky. Common sense sometimes not so common.
Exactly.
Now let me ask you, since you are mobile, right?
Yes, sir.
If someone were to get a flat on the side of the road,
I'll
do you have a
there.
radius that you'll come to them?
I'll tell you what. The farthest I went so far is an hour and 30 minutes away.
Wow. All right.
And it comes down to, again, if you're willing to pay, then I don't mind coming down.
That's true. That's the way it is. That's it. Oh, I got it.
It is what it is. Business is business. You know, there's people that, you know, we can't afford it sometimes. And yes, I will work with you. I don't mind working.
You go on a payment plan.
forget even the payment
plan. Not with a tire. Okay, so if people want to find you, you have a social media presence, you have a website, a phone number, how can somebody find you to make an appointment?
Facebook.
Okay.
Facebook/Texidor Motorcycle Tires. And then you can reach me, and I have my number there, and it has pretty much all the information.
Perfect.
There.
Great. Our IT John put it on there for you, so that's great.
Sir.
Everybody, look at that. Go to his Facebook page anyways. Like it.
Yes, like it, love it, follow it.
That's it. And then let him know when you need a tire.
Yes, sir.
All right, man. Well, thanks for coming out and letting us know, man. It's always good to have somebody in the industry.
Well, if I get a nail, I'm going to be calling your ass.
Hey, I can put a nail in if you want. I don't mind.
I was about to say, you drive around with nails? Just, you know, I was just wondering, like,
nah.
Hey, I noticed your tire's out.
No.
Well, thanks, man. Well, I'll definitely give you a call when I need a tire. I know Rick was talking to you.
Yeah,
so.
I'm sure on the back of my tire.
He's been putting a lot of miles on lately, so.
Stop riding. I've had the bike for a year yesterday, and I've got over 20,000 miles. And my 1-year anniversary was yesterday.
There you go. That's a lot of miles.
A lot of miles. All right, man. Well, thank you.
Thanks for
coming
in.
See you around in a bit.
Yes, sir.
It's nice meeting you, Rick.
Yes, sir.
Are we going to go to a commercial? What are we doing
now? We'll go to the
first of all, I'm laughing because you know we can't get through a show without Dad calling.
No. You know I don't like when he's on the phone, right?
So
he's calling
he's
me
calling
while I'm talking. Yeah.
I'm like, who else could it be calling when we're in the middle of a show? My dad's got to call and say
what happened was he did call and say, is that your bike in the back? And I said, yeah. And he's like, oh, my God.
It's his bike. Yes, we've all said, is that your bike? Yeah, it's his bike.
Yes,
and I took it for a ride, and I'm going to tell Rick took it. It handles beautifully, I will tell you that. Well, stick around. We're going to show you a clip. And I don't know if you know what we do with the Predators, okay, every home game.
Oh, okay.
We ride the dancers in onto the field, all right?
Really?
Yeah, we love it. And then we stream all their games live through our, what do we do it through? We do it through our Facebook and our YouTube, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So hopefully you guys been watching us.
Live.
CFTV.live. Sorry, IT John. I know you're going to hit me in the head for that one.
I'll smack him here, John.
So we all take care of that. So what we had, Crazy John wasn't here for the inaugural run. Rick wasn't here either. But it was Crazy John's crazy idea. Somehow he got this idea that we should let people try to kick a football into a grocery cart.
35 yards.
And if they do, you know what they get? No, you don't know, do you? Okay, let me tell you what they get.
Okay.
They get $20,000 towards the purchase of a motorcycle.
Wow.
And that's with who?
With iMotorsports.
iMotorsports. So, yep, we had two people come out, give it a try. We had a blast.
It's all one roll and hit the carrot.
Yeah,
cart. They were
He hit the cart.
And that's the first ones that ever done it. So, you know, they choose two people. It's going to be pretty cool.
But we had a great time with it. So, IT John's got